And like I said, really getting used to the idea that living your dream life isn't necessarily a dream. And sure. I think Adam's going to be able to tell you a little bit about that too. But I think that's just...
One thing that I've found is that when I've gone through this journey of not settling and figuring out what did I want to do, what did I want my purpose to be, I expected everything to be so much easier than, you know, my old life was in the bank. And it has been because I've been aligned to a focus, but it doesn't mean that day to day it's been sunshine and roses.
Exactly.
There's been days where I've gotten sucked back into the treadmill, you know, where... You know, I start to worry about why don't I know the answer to these things, or my supervisors at the university aren't available to give me what I want right now, or it looks like this person over here is doing a lot better than I'm doing. So just things that I thought I was above.
Right.
And so that's the important thing to realize is just because you have maybe moved off a path that you felt you weren't aligned to, or you weren't... that you'd settled with, you know, just because you move off that path into a path that you think this is more aligned to my life's purpose, doesn't mean that all those things are going to fade away, because again, that's an unrealistic expectation. It'll set you up for failure and feeling down. It's just important to realize, and I wish I'd realized that, is you're still going to have those days where you go, hold on a minute, I've fallen back, you know, into those kind of negative ways of looking at things. So, yeah. That's probably my story, I think.
All right. Well, and I was, as you were saying that, I was just thinking back to something that I don't mind sharing, just to show how quickly it can come back. Like you can fall back into the treadmill or the negative thought spiral or whatever you want to call it. So this was, gosh, I think maybe it's been like a month already now. It seems like it was just yesterday for some reason, or it seems like it was last week, but I bet it was a month ago. All of a sudden, I ended up in this weird negative spiral, which I hadn't experienced that in a very long time. Like, I don't actually remember the last time it was that bad before. I mean, from the time that I started pursuing the expectation gaps full time to that point, I don't remember it being that bad. And it was kind of predicated by, so I do accounting work on the side still to pay the bills, because, you know, we don't have people buying us equipment yet. So another plug for coffee there. So I still had to do some accounting work on the side, which is great. I love my clients that I'm working with, and that's all good. But the point is, as accounting goes, it's kind of an industry where it's an all or nothing kind of industry. And sometimes they're just slow times. It was the first time since I started doing accounting work again that I was completely caught up. And I started freaking out a little bit, because all of a sudden, and then I started overanalyzing things and like, well, what if this client goes out of business? Or what if this client decides not to do this anymore? What if that client, like these clients that I have already? And I just started really overanalyzing everything. And I got in this huge spiral where I was just freaking out. Like, I was freaking out so bad. I was driving Emma to school. Oh, sorry, my daughter's Emma. Anyway, Adam knows that. But I was driving my daughter Emma to school, and I almost felt like numb. Like, is the best way I can describe it, because I had just freaked myself out so bad. And so anyways, then I got home and I called Dan, my husband. And I'm like, I'm freaking out. I just don't know why I'm freaking out. And I actually started crying, because, which is weird for me, because I don't hardly ever cry.
Yeah.
I just don't. And so anyways, he kind of talked me down a little bit. And then I started just working again. And I just started, okay, what can I do today to either make that problem better or just forget that it's not even a problem. It really wasn't even a problem. It was this problem I was creating in my head. Mm. What can I do right now? And so I just started working, and it helped. That and the combination of talking to Dan, of course, helped. And yeah, and then I was, the thing is, after that, I was absolutely fine. Like, it was gone. As quickly as it came, it was gone again.
Yeah.
So that's what I mean. It's like, I've been doing this forever, and I, not forever. I like to exaggerating a little bit, apparently. Yeah, I've been doing this forever. It feels like forever. Because I really don't remember. It's really hard to remember a time before I was working on the expectation gaps full time. But anyways, I've been doing it a long time, like a year and a half, and it still hit me out of the blue like that. And I write about it all the time. I talk about it all the time, about not settling and about being conscious and controlling your emotions and all this stuff. And it still hits. So it doesn't matter. It's going to come whether you have, no matter how prepared you are.
I think that's a really important point you just said, you know, how quickly you snap back to how you were before.
Right.
That's the most powerful thing I think people can realize, is that it's that adage. I can't remember if it's a Persian adage, which is, this too shall pass.
Okay.
And the good thing about this too shall pass.
Is that the thing you have on your phone?
Yes.
As a reminder to yourself that pops up on your phone?
Yes.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, for anyone who doesn't know, so I've got a reminder on my phone every day at 12 o'clock just to have, this too shall pass. What's interesting about that, though, is I've had that on my phone so long now, when I look at those words, I only really register them if I'm fully conscious. Now it just goes, this too shall pass, oh yeah, cool, whatever. Okay. So you really need to take that time to listen or observe. Anyways, so for people who don't know, the importance of this too shall pass is, if you're having a bad time, it's to know that that bad time will fade. Everything in life is transient, and vice versa for the good. If things are going well, enjoy that moment, because that moment will fade. Right. And I can completely agree with Amanda. I was having an absolutely shit time with my mental health last week. And in the moment of feeling really, really down, I just felt, the world was collapsing in on me and everything was terrible. But then this week I've been great.
Yeah.
And it's, you know, people are like messaging me and asking if I'm feeling okay. And I'm like, yeah, I'm fine. I'm great. It's, you know, I'm in a really good headspace.
Right.
And almost reading or thinking about me last week, completely different person, it feels like. So it's just to remember in those moments that it'll pass. It will pass. And it's hard to know in those moments. But yeah.
Well, and I guess it just reminded me of something too. Maybe a good point is what you're striving for. So when you're working on any type of personal development, I think whatever it might be, we're not striving for perfection here. We're striving for progress. And I think the difference in our stories for both of us is that if we would have fallen into that negative spiral or whatever you want to call it, before we had done all this personal development work, it would have taken us a lot longer to come out of it.
Yeah.
Where I wouldn't have been able, mine lasted, less than 24 hours. I mean, and that's including sleeping. So, where before maybe that would have been my whole week.
Yeah.
And so that's really the difference. It's not that it's going to completely go away, but you become aware of it much sooner. And you become able to deal with it much. And like I said, I knew right away, I need to call Dan. Like maybe before I wouldn't have had someone in mind that I knew I need to call this person.
Yeah.
Because this person is going to get me out of this. They know what to say to get me out of this. So that's part of it too. That's part of the personal development, of getting the right people around you so that they can help you pull out of it. And that's all taking time. I've been working on this. I mean, I've been working on the expectation gaps for a year and a half, as I've said, but I've been working on living with intention for at least 10 years. So, and you know, it's a long, long process. And I think I've probably said that on the show before too, but and I haven't perfected it yet, and I don't expect to perfect it. I just expect that I'm going to be able to deal with it better, and that's about it.